Albion Online is receiving a big update named Lands Awakened on November 24. But what's exactly new with this update and what does it mean for the future of the game and the players? If you haven't heard about Albion before, it's good to know that it's a free-to-play sandbox MMORPG which you can play on PC and mobile. With its unique art style, player-driven economy, classless system, full loot feature, and enormous variety of content, the game has a huge active player base. Through their updates, Sandbox Interactive, the company behind Albion Online, shows they value community feedback, as many points that typically frustrated players have been addressed with the Lands Awakened update. Along with tackling a lot of the common issues, this update also raises the skill ceiling for the player base and once again provides a ton of new content. Starting with the massive biome rework and improvements, the graphics of the world of Albion are becoming prettier than ever. All 5 biomes within the game received a complete overhaul with this update. What's even more impressive, and what I think is a really great decision by SBI, is that there will be a fast difference between low, middle, and high tier zones within each biome. So the higher tier zones you decide to play in, the more beautiful they will look. Higher tier zones already gave you the advantage of receiving more rewards, such as loot and fame, but the game previously didn't feel any different when playing in a starter zone versus playing in an endgame zone. But now, the improved graphics will make you feel like you truly advance within the game as you progress. With Lands Awakened, you now have even more reason to advance to higher levels. As for the more competitive PvP players of Albion Online, SBI is also changing the layouts of each zone by adding unique landscape features. Along with improvements to the minimap, which will make it clearer to read, these changes will make for a ton of new opportunities to use the various maps to your advantage within your battles. A second big change to the game with the Lands Awakened update are the new and reworked open world gameplay objectives. If you have been around for a while, you undoubtedly noticed that over time, the game became more instance oriented. There wasn't much incentive for players to roam the open world any longer or put their gear at risk. With the upcoming changes, however, players will have many reasons to roam the open world of Albion once again. These changes include upgrades to open world mobs that will make them more powerful and rewarding as long as they aren't killed. Each mob can now upgrade multiple times, making for more loot and fame with every upgrade. So if you happen to find an area where no other player has been farming for a while, you will have tons of loot and fame up for the grabs. Mobs within static dungeons have also been reworked and received the same treatment as those in the open world. Furthermore, static dungeons as a whole have been reworked and feature new events. Not only the mobs, but also the chests and bosses within static dungeons will become more valuable over time. And with the new Dungeon Rush event that will randomly boost the upgrade rate of the mobs within particular dungeons, static dungeons will become something far more interactive that's always worthy of exploring. I think the changes to the mobs in the open world and the changes to the static dungeons will improve the open world experience greatly. And I think it's exactly what the game needs to deliver on its original promise of being a high-risk, high-reward type of game. Many players felt like Albion Online kept straying away further from its original promise, as everything became more instanced and safe. With highly rewarding content such as hardcore expeditions, one could do safely without leaving town and no risk of losing gear, the open world of Albion started losing any meaning it had to it. So it's nice to see these type of changes with the Lands Awakened update that rewards players for taking risks within their gameplay. Another great change that comes to the open world with the Lands Awakened update is the treasure rework. Right now, the treasures within Albion Online are static and have fixed times in which players can loot them. The rewards these treasures currently provide aren't worth contesting over either. This makes the current treasure feature very unappealing, whilst when they were originally implemented, they were a great source of rewards and PvP. Solo players would fight over smaller chests, whereas bigger chests were contested by larger groups from various guilds. With the upcoming treasure rework, treasures now spawn randomly anywhere in the open world where PvP is possible, rather than at fixed locations. They will come in 3 different sizes, which are small, medium, and large. Once these chests spawn, they will be locked for a time depending on their size before they can be claimed. This will provide players a chance to prepare to contest for said chests. turning treasure chests into yet another interactive open world objective with PvP action and rewards. This is the type of content I have a lot of fond memories of from the early days, and a change I'm really happy to see. I have no doubt that the treasures from Lands Awakened will make for plenty of PvP action and many great memories for the players involved. Another thing is, Albion Online is a full loot game, and because of this, many players tend to wear lower tier items because higher tier gear tends to be expensive and difficult to come by. Therefore, it's good to hear that another change with the Lands Awakened update is to the highest tier resources within the game, in which the number of charges on tier 7 and tier 8 resources increases greatly. Although the amount of charges on the updated resources will be random, overall the global output of resources will increase. Even larger nodes will have increased charges, and from now on they will be visible on the map as long as they aren't harvested. As you can already guess, this will turn these nodes into huge points of interest that players will typically compete over. Along with a few more changes to mid-tier resources, resource mobs, and even resource guardians, there will be a big boost to the output of resources within the game. I think this change was highly necessary as the population of Albion Online is bigger than ever. A boost to mid and high tier resources means more gear that can be crafted, sold, and used by players. And since large nodes will also be marked on the map moving forward, at the very same time it also promotes open world PvP, which is exactly what Albion Online needs more of. 105 different weapons weren't enough, so with the Lands Awakened update, the game is also receiving an entire new weapon line, Warglows. This means Albion Online will have 7 new weapons, 15 new abilities, and some unique passives. The Warglows are melee focused and offer damage, mobility, and control abilities, along with limited ranged abilities. This of course also means crafters will have something new to work on within their Destiny boards. If you ask me, new weapons and armors are always a welcome addition to the game, and I'm definitely looking forward to more. FBI decided to shift the focus of Guild Seasons away from territorial control towards player activity. The reward system of Guild Seasons have been reworked, and starting with Lands Awakened, the Conqueror's Challenge will be introduced. Something interesting about this challenge is that it's open to all players, so not only to players that are guild affiliated. The Conqueror's Challenge consists of 2 new reward systems, which are Might and Favor. These unlock rewards such as seasonal battle mounts, pain boosts, new avatars, siphoned energy, and loot chests. You will be able to earn Might and Favor by doing activities which carry a risk of PvP. There are a lot of details to the total changes of the reworked Guild Seasons, and honestly, at this point, I'm still having difficulties grasping all of it myself, but the Conqueror's Challenge is definitely a very interesting part of it that applies to the entire player base. I think anything that promotes additional rewards for taking risks is great, and a new layer of rewards through the Conqueror's Challenge that all players can benefit from was exactly that. Other changes within the Guild Seasons target hideouts, introduce power cores and energy crystals that are bound to make for fierce and constant competition, and a lot of PvP action between different guilds within the Outlands. If you thought that with the new patch you'd only be busy leveling Warglows, you were wrong. Because aside from having 7 new excuses to farm fame, you have a much bigger one, which are the new elite levels. Each weapon within the game, meaning all 112 weapons moving forward, will have 20 additional elite combat specialization levels. These can be unlocked by spending fame credits and silver, and give the same amount of item power as the regular levels. For your great achievements of leveling them, specialization medal icons will appear on equipped items in your inventory, showing all other players the effort you've put into them. I'm hugely in favor of personal and guild achievements being visualized, and the specialization medal icons, in my opinion, are a solid addition. Now, if the elite level scared you off because you didn't even max out one of your weapons yet, you will be happy to hear the overall amount of fame earned for most activities will increase significantly. This increase is between 20 to 50% for a lot of the content, with the exception of some activities that already offer very high levels of fame, such as Slayer difficulty Corrupted Dungeons and Hardcore Expeditions. So not only do players have new sources of fame with this update, but old sources of fame become more appealing too. As you can expect, with every big update, Lance Awakened will also have quality of life and UI improvements. Most noticeably, and probably the biggest one on the list, is that loadouts can now be purchased via the marketplace. This means you will spend even less time managing items, which will give you more time to farm fame and acquire loot. Other items on this list affect item rerolling, party improvements, and improvements to farming. Now, I'm someone that always has music off in whatever game I play because I find it pretty distracting. But with the Lance Awakened update, the game soundtrack has been significantly expanded and updated. Music for various features have been newly added or greatly expanded. Features such as the Royal Cities and Carleon, Combat and Bosses, Hideouts, the Tutorial, Starter Towns, and even the Destiny Board. I guess I'll be turning my music back on with the Lance Awakened update, because from the sneak peeks of the full orchestral recordings, I can already tell I'd most definitely be missing out. Another very noticeable and game-changing part of the Lance Awakened update is the nerf to ganking, which comes in multiple ways. First of all, the mount changes will increase the base health of mounts by 20 to 60% based on the type of mount. So gankers will have a much more difficult time in dismounting other players. The ganker's favorite, Poison Potion, which is the biggest resource in catching other players, is also receiving multiple punches with this update. The range of the Poison Potion is getting nerfed by 20%, the amount of ticks is reduced from 7 to 5, and the poison duration is lowered from 6 seconds to 3 seconds. Or in other words, it's going to become more difficult for gankers to slow players down with their Poison Potions, and the window in which they have to expand on this resource is becoming smaller as well. Last but not least, some of the most popular ganking weapons and armors are getting nerfed, in which their effects won't last as long, and multiple of the same crowd controls will make for diminishing returns, allowing victims to stand a better chance of escaping. All of these changes will truly separate the good gankers from the bad gankers, as it will require much more coordination and communication to successfully pull off ganks. Solo ganking, however, will most likely not be the best option any longer, but with the amount of players roaming the open world from here on, you're probably better off in a fighting set when you want to roam for kills on your own anyway. In conclusion, with the Lance Awakened update, the open world of Albion Online is receiving a big boost in many different ways. Risk versus reward is finally returning as a core aspect of the game, in which players will be rewarded heavily and in various ways, participating in activities that have a chance for PvP. With the new Warglove weapon tree and elite levels, players will have plenty of new things to get busy with. Newer players will have an easier time getting started with the game because of the changes to the tutorial, they will progress much quicker because of fame boosts to various content, and they will have a fairer chance of surviving in the open world because of the overall nerf to ganking. Aside from everything mentioned in this video, this update will also bring new achievements, various fixes, new spell icons, and a bunch of other changes and improvements that I haven't even mentioned. So do I think whether Albion Online is worth playing with the Lance Awakened update? I'm convinced that this update will be the best state of Albion Online ever since release. Don't forget that over the years we already had a lot of amazing features and content added to the game, such as the most competitive Crystal League, most challenging and beautiful Avalonian raids, the Roads of Avalon, which added an entire new world of content to the game, and all the other bits and pieces that were refined over time to become great and enjoyable. And now with the Lance Awakened update bringing everything together by dragging the open world to the foreground once again, I'm fired up and ready to go. And you should be too. I'll see you in Lance Awakened on November 24.